Hello, it's Keith from KMA's Korner. How are you doing? Well, I'm doing fine, thank you for asking. I am back on my Minecraft Uncut world. For you, hello, Betsy. Mwah! Yeah, I just wanted to come over for a kiss. I haven't been on this world for 3 weeks. Even though episodes have been uploading every single day for 3 weeks, I haven't been here. I figured I got way ahead of myself, and that was uncool. So what I decided to do was, as you know, I started some more series so I can get my fill of Minecraft. Oh, let me just check my options because everything changes whenever I do things. La 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 la. Okay, I am back. I don't know why all these cows are out. Jerks! Listen to that noise. So yeah, I got myself way ahead. So people were asking me questions about things that happened to me 3-4 weeks ago, and I said that's kind of uncool because I'm out of the loop. I have to go look at the video again to find out what the question is about, and that's just not good YouTubing. So I decided to stop doing this for a little while. And let the episodes catch up to where I actually am. And, trying to refresh my memory of what I'm doing. Actually, I need some of you. I wish I had another stack of... I do have another stack of you. But I don't have any dirt. No dirt? Okay. So basically I have got myself caught up in life. Now instead of recording this 3-4 weeks ahead of time, I'm recording it about a week ahead. And seeing that I've been away from here for so long, I kind of forgot what I was doing. More good YouTubing stuff. So, what I have an idea of today, what I'm doing today. And let's see how everything's doing over here. Yeah, I don't need to do all that. I would like to find some dirt, because I would like to make some coarse dirt. And why would somebody in Minecraft want to make some coarse dirt? I just wanna... I only have 4 pieces of dirt. I guess there's been lots of... Oh, thank you guys for all shutting up. I guess there's been lots of creeper explosions, so I haven't had the dirt. So, I'm gonna go over to the King's Mine and see if... Let me bring... See if I got some dirt over there. Basically, what I plan on doing is taking this section right here and making a path. So that's the only reason why people would want coarse dirt, is to make a path. Yeah. And a lot of things have happened in my life for the last 3 weeks, as I've made note in other videos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a lot of new series also. And one other thing I'm changing, and for this series... Oh, you know what I should do? Fuck yeah. Excuse my language. But I keep forgetting to bring it over. How many do I need to bring over? Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna bring over 4 soul sands. So I can finish, well, not finish the boat dock, but finish the dock on the other side, which would be nice. So yeah, this is going to be the first week of this series changing just a tad, because all the other episodes that I had recorded, I had already uploaded, and it was just waiting for regular time and the planet to catch up with time in my Minecraft world. Or basically had to wait for a lot of these videos to be uploaded and seen. So I have added new series. I'm doing a CTM map called Sea of Flames, which you've seen a few episodes of already, and I have started a single player edited world, and I have restarted my Athens snapshot server world, and with hopes of playing with other people and collaborating, because, yeah, that's what we do. And, what I had decided when I created all these extra things, I have this series that runs every single freaking night of the week. I don't need it to run every single freaking night of the week. And as a matter of fact, the longer the episode is, the smoother these, this series goes. So what I have decided was to double up the episodes each night. Can I place blocks from being inside here? Oh, I can. Ooh. How special. So, I, instead of releasing 6 20-minute episodes a week, I'm going to release Enderman damage. I'm going to upload 3 dirt, please. Come on. That's not enough. Let's just see something here. I'm going to take half. I'm going to take half. So that each one of these makes 4. So, that's 64. I'm going to start with 64. I'll keep those on me. Let's go down. Oh. You know, again, because I am so awesome at doing this. I didn't finish my statement. So instead of doing 6 20-minute episodes a week, I'm going to do 3 40-minute episodes a week. So I'm still going to do the 2-hour recording like I always have, but instead of splitting it up into 6 20s, I'm going to split it up into 3 40s, because I don't want to be uploading more than one video a day. And with the other series going on, that is what's happening. That is what's happening. I'm stealing you. What else can I steal? Do I want to put andesite down in the ground? No, because I'm using way too much andesite for this job. What am I missing? I'm thinking, you know, I'm thinking about the pathways, and I thought there was 4 blocks I wanted to use. And right now, I'm only thinking of 3, which would be coarse dirt, gravel, cobblestone. Well, we can start with that, and then we can... This is insanely stupid. I might as well get this out of the way right now. I want stairs here. So, I'm gonna make another stack of stairs. We'll use them eventually if I don't use them all now. I sound so positive there. Okay. So as I get out of here, I'm gonna throw up the stairs. Throwing them up. Okay. So, 3 40-minute episodes, which are going to be uploaded Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday. I keep throwing days of the week out. Sunday, fun day. Okay, I'll stop. The actual episodes will be released Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And on the Tuesday and Thursdays, the two T days, that's what I call them, the TT days, the titty days, I don't actually call them the titty days, but anyways, that's when the CTM See a Flame thing is going to be released. And on Saturday is going to be my single player world that I don't want my head hit. Ah, son of a sitch. I'm just... Okay, whatever. Whatever. Forgive me. I just got home from work. So, on Tuesday and Thursday, I'm going to do the CTM map. And right now, the CTM map is Sea of Flames. And I suck bad at it. And I actually had my first scary scream like a girl sound the other day. That probably going to be uploaded, or actually it's probably has been uploaded already. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, this series, Tuesdays, Thursdays, the other series, the CTM map series, which when I'm done with Sea of Flames, I'll go to another series, another Vex map, most likely. And then on Saturday, I'm going to upload the single player edited version, my, that will be my baby. And then on Sunday, I will be uploading, what's it called? The Athens server snapshot survival thingy-ma-jiggy. So that will, you know, one video a day for the week, which is fine. Now, there was an exception. You didn't hear me say Minecraft Cut, which is the series that I did, which is kind of the highlights from each week of this series. I'm pretty sure I'm going to end that series. I asked the other night, or last night, on Twitter, the Twitters, that should I continue with the Cut series or not. And honestly, I came home from work, and I turned on the computer. I said, I got a couple hours. I can record Minecraft Uncut for the first time in weeks. I should do it. I'm going to kill myself because I think my boat is someplace where it doesn't think it is. Okay. Let's see what happens. Don't die. Oh, good. Good. Good boat. So, yeah, completely forgot what I was just talking about. Yeah. I think, well, let's go from the other side and work our way towards the boat dock. I'm just gonna randomly place blocks. That's how it goes in this world. Coarse dirt. I might as well put some stairs in there, and I might as well take that. So I may or may not add a Minecraft Cut. I think that series is done. No more Minecraft Uncut. Unless you guys like are going, ah, you motherfucker, I need that show. Then, yeah. I'll spend the extra time and put it out there for you. But I'm pretty sure that that's not going to be happening. Let's put a little coarse dirt there. Coarse dirt there. I'm going to try and do this with... Oh, that's not looking good. I'm going to try and do this without looking too weird. Just random. I can do random. Yeah. I'm going to need more than what I grabbed. That. So what has happened since I've recorded this episode last? Not really much. The end of season came. I have a lot more free time. I'm happy about that. But the sad thing is, I am going to just make a little path so I know exactly where I'm going. I'm going to make a bridge over this. I don't know if I'm going to do it today. It's just a simple little bridge, so it's not something I go, tune in next week for this awesome motherfucking bridge. It's just going to be a bridge. I am going to talk a little bit about my job for a change. Well, after I tell you more about the loan thing. It has something to do with the whole job situation. But I am glad to tell you now that the loan thing has been fixed. We basically got all our money back and are wiser because of it. Do we want to... Oh, you know what I can do? I'm like jumping all over the place because I haven't been here in so long. And I'm just excited to be on this thing, yeah. Not really. Well, kinda. Kinda get sick of worlds a little bit, and I think I got a little sick of this one. Because digging in the nether, getting to the other places wasn't the funnest thing in the world to do. So what am I looking for? I am looking for some of these mother truckers, and I don't wanna... Let's put the torches away, we don't need that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here. I need vines because my 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Woo! My, can I reach it? Yes, just barely. My blah, 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 blah. I totally forgot again what I was talking about. Jeez Louises. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is kind of what I do. And then when the vines grow, you can just knock them off. But kind of like that. Yeah. That's the ticket. Let's build one more for now. Just for this one solely lonely thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my my King's Mine place is very mossy cobblestone intensive. This is gonna be too much fun. Come here. Come here. I can't even see you anymore. So, so things happened. My job forgot to pay me for some days. We were running a little bit behind on bills. I kind of went through the story on another video in another series, but seeing that this is a different series and there's been some resolution to it, I'm just going to explain a little bit more of what kind of happened. So we were running a little bit behind on bills. Usually in the winter time down here, I'm working all sorts of crazy hours. But the route I chose was super uber easy. So instead of showing up at work, even though it was one of the higher hourly paid, higher paying routes, it was super, super, super easy. So I was showing up to work an hour and a half, 2 hours later than I used to last winter, where I was making some buco butts. No, I wasn't making butts. I was making bucks. So, yeah, I'm gonna lower this down. Just so... I don't know. I think the bridge can go across here. Let's just terraform this a little bit. Yeah. It looks almost a little too Oh, nice. Good thing I got the diamond one. I had to get one up my sleeve. So, we were kind of struggling with the bills a little bit. And then they forgot to pay me for a couple of days. And with where I work and like any government association place, it takes forever and a day to get anything fixed. So I knew I was out that money for a couple of weeks. And we needed money right away, which put us in the thing of, why won't you let me place you? Oh, because you can't place food. Minecraft for beginners. So we decided to go get a loan, and I let Stacy do everything, pick the loan company, you know, talk to the people. She does all the financial stuff because I work so much and I don't want to deal with it because I suck at it also. And I say also because, yes, she sucks at it too. So she found a loan company and she handed me the phone, said, hey, do these guys sound reputable? And I'm like, okay. Do you sound reputable? Well, you sound like an Indian dude. Well, I guess Indian dudes like to do customer service or whatever. Broad generalization, borderline racism there, I know. So I'm like, well, they seem okay. What's the name of the company? And they told me the name of the company. And I went up and I looked up their website. And I'm like, oh, this is legit. And then I handed the phone back to Stacy and basically said, I'm going to go look them up on the BB, Better Business Bureau, the 3Bs. And I did. And they came up with one complaint. So we were like, yeah, these guys seem legit. I'm only going to take 64? Yeah. So I kind of gave Stacy the heads up on, you know, go right ahead, do whatever they say. And some of the things they said were a little strange that kind of gave us clues that things, see, it's already growing. Things might not be right. So, yes, things were not right. We called the initial company, this is all embarrassing, and asked them, hey, do you have any offices in New York? Because that's where this guy was stating they were from. And they said, no, we don't have anything in New York. These people are scamming you. Don't use them. Because we don't have anything in New York. And if they're affiliated with us, we would know about it. Unless it's a satellite office. And we're kind of given the hope, like, oh, unless it's a satellite office. Well, it must be a satellite office. So I kind of said, I don't know. It sounds a little fishy, but it's up to you. We need the money bad, Stacy. If we don't get the loan, we're screwed. And if we do get the loan, we won't be screwed. And these guys are asking for $300 in proof of the loan. Actually, it was $200, $190 and some 48 cents or something stupid like that. And they're like, yes, can you go get us that and an Amazon card? And we're kind of like, whoop, another red light, Amazon card. What company asks for a payment on an Amazon card? And they're like, oh no, it's just to prove that you can pay us back when it comes time to paying us back. So it's like middle of the week, you didn't know we were going to ask you this, and if you have the money and you can put it on an Amazon card, we can check the card. You can keep the Amazon card and spend it on Amazon or get it for a refund. But it just shows that in the middle of the week, you have money, and that kind of proves to us that you can pay back the debt. So I'm like, oh, kind of sounds a little fishy, but I might as well. So she got the Amazon card. Then they approved us for the loan because we gave them the Amazon card. And then, they said, okay, we are going to wire the money to your bank at this time. So what we need is another payment for the wire transaction fees. And this payment was for another $164. And if you want, put it on Amazon because we are, affiliated with Amazon. And I'm like, well, I'm affiliated with Amazon too. So if I would take payments with Amazon cards, so why not you? So, more red flag that we should have known about. And we just kind of like, we needed the money so bad that it got to the point where I actually told Stacy, if we decide not to get this loan for the rest of eternity, I will be questioning whether or not, how did that change? These guys were legit, and I will, never knowing the answer, that will mess, kind of fuck with my mind. So, I told her that and said, it's up to you whether or not you want to spend the other 100, whatever it was, for the wire transfer fee. So go right ahead, do what you think is best. To me, it would be worth risking the $150 just to see if they're a scam or not. And so we risked the money and gave them the Amazon card thingy. And they said, okay, well, thank you very much. We'll have the money in your account by 6:30 or 6:15. So at 6:30, Stacy calls them and the guy's like, yeah, you dumb bitch, we fucking scammed you. You guys even called the parent company and the parent company told you we were scam artists and you still gave us money. What a fucking bunch of dodo heads you are. And Stacy, I didn't actually hear this conversation, and they didn't use dodo head, I'm paraphrasing obviously. So I'm just gonna get a couple of more course darts. So Stacy, being the person she is, goes, oh, that's pretty freaking mean. Why would you want to scam people you don't even know? And their voice says, we hate fucking Americans. We enjoy making your life sucky. So it was an anti-American thing. And the scary thing is with all the Muslim hate in this country, and India is pretty Muslim filled. It's like half Muslim, half Buddhist. And I tend to forget that India is a very I forget that they have a lot of Muslims there. And I'm a liberal, progressive thinker. And when people do broad Muslim hate, and I think to myself, Jesus, it's only like 1% of the population that really sucks ass. And, judging everybody that's Muslim because of a small percentage of suck-assers. I don't know, I must be thinking about sucking somebody's ass right now. I would give, you know, them a break in my head. And you hear all the news stories, oh, Muslims, they suck, whatever. But right now it's hard for me not to agree. And I hate to say that because I, like, look for excuses why we should not hate certain people or think of them in a certain light. But they're just as... This is going to be... In my mind, they're just as bad as the old white folks that are ultra-conservative in this country that's taking money away from schools and poor people and giving it to the rich corporations because that's the ones... That's because Fox News tells them that's how it's supposed to be or whatever. I don't really want to get political, but you kind of know my stance already. Now, So, yeah, it kind of sucked. We were out the $400. They had our bank account number, our routing number for the check. They have my driver's license and my driver's license number. They have all that wonderful stuff. And here we are, behind in bills, ready to pay our landlord rent. And I just got paid, and there's a bunch of money sitting there, and these guys at any second can go in and drain all the funds. So we went on panic mode immediately. So what has happened since? Initially, I made a video stating, because I thought they were going to do this, the bank account has been drained. We have no money for food or whatever. And I guess these people didn't care about our bank account, because I was thinking about it later. Why would they want Amazon cards if they were going to just drain our account anyways? Just get our bank account number and drain our account. But they weren't going to do that. They were just looking for a few $100, which thankfully happened. So we changed our bank account. We changed our bank account routing number. We actually got all new debit cards just in case. I put a fraud alert back on my credit because in the past, some Jose Montana tried to buy some stuff underneath my name. Somehow he got my information. And I had a fraud alert on there. That's getting a little broad over here. I said brown. So that was all changed. My license is going to stay the same. So these people have my driver's license number and what I look like. Which I guess is fine. Not much can happen. Because of the fraud alert, if anything did happen, it would, you know, throw up red flags everywhere. So we're kind of safe. But we're still out the $400. And so what Stacy has been doing, she's talked to the police. We got the police report. We gave the police report to Amazon. Stacy took a picture of her with the receipts for the gift cards, the $400-something worth of gift cards, and Amazon finally, after a few days of arguing, decided that yes, we were actually stolen from, we're not the thieves. And we need our money back. Hey! I could use your arrow. Where are you? So Amazon, as of yesterday, returned the money that was stolen from us for the cards. Even whenever I hit the frickin' grass, I'm hearing creepers ready to explode. So that was pretty freaking awesome. I wouldn't even have thought to try and get the money back because I'd be like, well, we're the stupid idiots. Or, no, we deserve to get that money back. But Stacy has a way of dealing with companies and all that good stuff. Why is that one so much... Why are you already almost down all the way to the ground and these ones are just like up in the air? I wonder... I'm not gonna complain about it. I'm just gonna accept it. So... Sucky situation. Very tense. How are we going to feed ourselves? How is this going to happen? When are they going to drain our bank account? How are we going to pay our landlord? And stuff like that. I'm going to put one here. We even got... wrote up a new contract for our landlord and said, sorry, this is how it's going to have to be, or you're going to have to kick us out because we can't do any better than that. And our landlord agreed to it. He knew what happens. He's not happy with it, but, you know, whatever. I understand. I wouldn't be happy with it either. So, we are back to even, I guess. Shit. And hopefully this will be the last time I have to talk about it. Because it is quite embarrassing. For me, for Stacy, for everyone involved. And, by the way, the idiots who took the card said the name that, well, it's obviously probably fake names, but the police are looking into it. They know where the cards were purchased. They know where the IP is. They're coming pretty close to finding these people. And as a matter of fact, I have actually called these people up. They still have the same phone number, which they'll change in a week or two. And I've talked to the guy who scammed us after he scammed us. And I said, you know, good job. You got us. Good job. Fucking jerk. Thank you for scamming us. We deserved it because we suck. Don't hate Americans like you do. We're actually much better people than you think. Brainwashed with misinformation and biased thoughts. But yeah, I'll definitely, you know, stick the guy in jail if he's ever caught. And, you know, the names that they used was really bad. And I there's things, you know, hindsight 2020, there's things I wish I'd done. Thought about doing in the time that it was happening, but never actually did anything about it because I wanted the loan would have made our lives so much easier. And at the same time, I'm kind of glad it didn't work because I didn't really feel like paying a couple hundred dollars a month for 4 or 5 years of my life. Life is a long lesson. Keep your eyes open and learn from your mistakes and you'll do fine. So everything's basically fixed with that. But that was our bad time. Embarrassing. Whatever time you want to consider it. Hoping this thing looks okay. So what else has happened? I told you about... Is this even looking okay? Kind of does. It's not great. But...